gonna tell you a story. I'm gonna tell you about my town. I'm gonna tell you a big fat story, baby. It's all about my town. Yeah, down by the river. Down by the river.
We're really thrilled to have Lenny Kaye, one of the all-time record geeks on planet Earth. Why don't we see what you got here, Lenny?
Well, this was my best find, I think. Dick Dale, Taco Truck. I'm having a big instrumental time these days. I'm sure this is a great record. I really don't know what it sounds like, but part of the pleasure records that you don't have to know, because I'll see Taco Wagon and I'll say, yes. I'd like an enchilada, please. What else we got? Rory Gallagher. Probably one of my top five guitar players, a great strato blueser. I have tons of his records. I know I have this on vinyl, but maybe if I'm in the car and I want to slide it in, I can have this too. What else do we have here? Kristen Hersh's Hips and Makers.
You can't get any more sunshine. You can't get any more broken down. Oh, no, no, no.
This is just a little billboard for it because I produced this album with Kristen, and it's a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful record, intimate and just filled with those emotional moments that make her one of the most enlightening artists. So, here's a group that I love, The Best of Budgie. When you talk about British heavy metal in the time of Black Sabbath, Budgie was my favorite group. I was really excited when we played in Chicago in the late 70s to find them on the bill. It was their first, probably, and only tour in America. I beg to differ with whoever put this together because the true best of Budgie is a song called Guts from their debut album, and it's not on here. However, they have Napoleon Bona Part 1 and 2. They're a funny group, Ain't No Mountain. Very heavy, In the Grip of a Tire Fitter's Hand. That's one of the titles. What else we got here? Blues Project, Parchment Farm.
Well, I'm sitting over here on Parchment Farm. Yes, I'm sitting here on Parchment Farm.
This was probably one of the most influential bands when I was growing up, to see them take the blues and kind of move it into progressive rock really helped me take whatever knowledge I had of blues, which was fairly limited, and imagine myself playing at the Cafe Go-Go, where I believe this live picture was taken, backed with bright lights in Big City. Okay, here's a record I found in the piles. It's by Los Pop Tops. I have it in a picture sleeve, sorry, it's really nice. They were dressed in, kind of frilly, 17th century garb.
I feel the weight of their everlasting hate, yet I still live with hope and faith.
Ooh, ooh,
I wait a change, but nothing ever.
What it is a backing track of Pachelbel's Canon, and they've sung words over it. Oh Lord, why Lord? It's a beautiful, beautiful record, and I think it really belongs in your record collection, because I'm not sure you know it.
I might have to check this out.
I have this record, and it's really one of the classics. I don't quite know what the flip side is, and don't we just love flip sides?
Yeah.
The B-sides, those wacky things they put on it, but this is a really great record. I'm a musical historian at root. I like to see the connectives and the way things tie up, and how if you keep moving a degree and a degree to here, you get a sense of spread of humankind's musical imagination. And I'm not just confining it to like 50s or 60s or 70s. I think music made today is like incredible. I think we're living through a new girl group renaissance, and will probably be remembered in the same way that we remember the greats of the Ronettes and the Chiffons and the Crystals and that whole wide expanse. I mean, you know, Katy Perry and Taylor Swift and Pink and Beyonce, Kelly Clarkson. These are great hit singles. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm not a musical snob and say, oh yeah, not enough art. If I want art, there's a lot of places I can go for art too, but give me a great chorus and a great hook and someone chirping away, you know, I'll turn up the radio for it. Of course, garage rock helped form who I could be. I helped immortalize my own sense of inspiration in it through the Blessed Nuggets collection, of which this is the 40th anniversary.
Hey, don't tell me what are you gonna do?
That comp had such an impact, though. I mean, I don't know. I know you know it just from in terms of how many things have been written about it.
But it
was
great.
The definitive collection of that stuff in the day that really sort of paved the way for who knows how many thousands of collections.
But you know, if you listen to it, it's not that. It's not as garagey as people. I mean, the word garage didn't even exist then. You know, I thought of there's a word coming around that rock critics use called punk rock. And, you know, it wasn't referred to anything except a kind of weird, you know, spirit of rebellion and, you know, that kind of presumptuousness.
Non-commercialism to a certain extent.
No, all of those bands wanted to make it. Yeah. I mean, the Seeds, you know, sure, they were happy to have that hit single.
It's called Pushing Too Hard.
We hope you like it. We think it's gassy.
A lot of the stuff that comes later is a little more generic in its definition. And while they're great records, I like the ones where the borders spill over and they don't really know what they're doing and they're, you know, aligning this wacky sound with that wacky sound. And you get something that, you know, that it's a happening by the Magic Mushrooms. It's just like, spray the weed, the zephyr breeze, a mushroom high above the clouds. I mean, you know, just crazy, crazy records. And, you know, they're all out there in your store. It's so great. You know, I worked in a record store. Patti and I met in a record store, Village Oldies, where she would come in and I'd put on the Blue Notes or Maureen Gray, and we danced Bristol Stomp, and, you know, we got friendly there. And I owe a lot to these places where people come to partake of music, and I just hope that there's more of them, and I congratulate you guys on having, I must say, the best record store in the world. There, I said it.
Well, thanks for saying that, but it's wonderful to see you, Lenny.
And I want to know, do you still need me as you did before?
Yeah. Amoeba!